Thank you. It's a quote by a young man named Dan Eldon. He was stoned to death in Somalia at the age of 23.
What a beast!
He was a photojournalist with Reuters. And he lived a really big life in a very short period of time. And he made these really beautiful diaries that were collages of the experiences he had. And when he passed, his family put out the book of his works. And it was titled, The Journey is the Destination. And that is so true. The journey is the destination. We have all of these really big goals that we think of all the time, and we forget these moments. And I have just been so blessed to have had so many moments, not of just meeting really great men like Dick Van Dyke backstage, or remarkable activists like Linda Sarsour, or Nomi Const. Yeah, she's my friend too. Kai Newkirk getting arrested with him at Democracy Spring in D.C. to overturn Citizens United. Joining those folks with Democracy Awakening, saying it's time to restore the VRA and give us our voting rights back. So many amazing people I've gotten a chance to speak with. And I'm so grateful that a big part of that has been seeing and getting to meet so many of you. That you keep showing up, not just making sure you're registering other people, because you have and you are, right?
Yeah.
So at that right hand, 11:59 p.m. you can still get some more peoples. More peoples. Not just making sure you're going to be voting by or on June 7th. I just came back from the voter registrar's office and just voted myself. Can do that. Who did I vote for?
Bernie Sanders!
Woo!
Bernie Sanders!
And I remember Ben Jealous, who used to be the head of the NAACP, was trying on me for quite some time to come out and stump for Bernie. I missed a meeting between him and Harry Belafonte. He said, if you had been in the room listening to Bernie Sanders and Harry Belafonte talking, you would have endorsed him right there. And I'm sad I didn't come out earlier, because he was right. Coming out here and seeing all of you, your diverse faces, finding diversity in age, in gender, in race, because it's not me, it's us. And this is true. I can see it from here, but I know you feel it in there. That this is good for the soul to come out and be together. And like Harry Belafonte said, this election is about the soul of America. So thank you so much for showing up. Despite the fact that, never mind the media, has told you you shouldn't even bother. But the other candidate herself has said that it's already done and I'm glad you boo about that, because the reality is what that is showing you, and this is what I keep saying, every single time they dismiss Bernie Sanders, they're dismissing you.
Oh yeah.
And be dismissed, clearly. The system is exposed now in a way, in real time. Often we would see how rigged certain things are, or biased certain things are, or corrupt certain things are years later. But because we're all talking to each other, we're exposing it in real time.
Yeah.
And that's power, everyone. That's real power.
Yeah.
And thank you for exercising that power, not just to register and vote, but to give your bodies to the cause, to give a face to this movement, because this is a movement, not a moment. And that's what they're not forgetting.
Yeah.
This is not about the destination. This is about the journey.
Yeah.
grateful to be on this journey with you. Believe me, you, I am with you all the way. To the primaries, to the convention, to the general election, and well beyond. Because no matter who becomes president, we've got a lot of work to do. And that's the thing that we've got to make really, really clear. Some of these signs. You know there's children's here. We got to know that there are a lot of people that we have to become aware of. Not just Bernie Sanders, but all the people down ticket, all of the people who make up our government. Because when they're telling us that your vote doesn't matter right now, but then on the other side talk about party unity, what they're really saying is that you need to fall in line and conform. They're just off by a couple letters. They meant reform. And that's what we are here to do. So I want to just say thank you so much for exposing what humanity looks like. Because that's what this means. When you're here and you're supporting Bernie Sanders, it's because you want universal health care for the strangers around you. You want education for the strangers around you. And you recognize that we've got money for war to hurt strangers. That we have an opportunity to make sure that they're not invisible, that those past mistakes, as some call them, don't have to be rewarded or perpetuated. That's what this vote means. This vote is about recognizing the invisible that too often get left behind. They were invisible oftentimes while they were alive, which is why they were expendable to begin with. But you have them in your hearts. I know you do. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here right now. And that's what gives me hope. That's what gets me out of bed every day. That's what gets me super excited and why I'm not worried about anything going forward. Because right now, as a 37-year-old woman in 2016, I recognize how significant this moment is. We are at the turn of a century. And anything and everything that they want to compare to the past, oh, this is just like, and you're going to do this because we said just like they did before. That's not what this moment is. They're still reading the last paragraph of an old book. And they're stuck on it. Wait, let me read it again. I'm not finished. We're like, nah. Time to turn the page. That chapter's done. As a matter of fact, I'm good on that book. Let's start a new one. The first page. And I want all of you to write in it. And tell your stories. And express your passion and your love and your commitment. Because I know you have it. And we can do that now. Because now the media doesn't get to have the last word anymore. So history is written by the winners. So we are going to win. Because we're on the right side of history. And that's what a political revolution means. And this is a long game. Okay, some of y'all will be like, I voted and it's gonna be just the end. No, it's not over. It's gonna take a minute. A few minutes. A lot of minutes. Because there's a lot of work to do. And I encourage you because I feel like, honestly, when I joined this campaign and watching and seeing the ebb and flow, the swells of the heart, and then the disenchantment that comes in. And then it swells again in anger, and then it comes back down in disappointment, and then it swells again. Well, I'm here to keep you going. I'm here to keep you fighting. I feel like my job is to encourage courage. And I know you have it in you to change not only this country, but the world, because what happens here has an effect around the entire planet. And understand, there are people who are fighting in the streets right now, all over the world. Our election is not the only election that is happening. And we need each other to see each other. The network for good has never been so vast, so big, and so connected. And that's what makes this moment different than anything we've seen before. They ignored us with the Occupy movement. They ignored us when we marched to prevent a war from happening, the first time in history that had ever happened. They avoided us when we said no to the bailout to Wall Street. How about you bail out Americans? Yeah. I remember watching a video with Jon Stewart, and he had an economist on his show, and he said, you know, if the amount of money in the bailout were to happen, and you were to give that to working people across America, it would be about $5,000-$6,000 per person. Do you think that that would change the economic downturn? And the economist was like, surprised. And he went, well, yeah. Wouldn't that have been amazing? Well, Wall Street's doing pretty good right now. And Bernie Sanders is calling on taxing their speculation for our kids' futures, their education. So, unfortunately, they didn't heed Jon Stewart, they didn't heed us. But it's never too late. They can still make good on this so-called promise of equality in the American dream. So now, let's show them how it's done. Yeah! We gotta encourage courage in them to keep going. Some of those people we need to encourage right now are those delegates. Yeah. Yeah. Delegates who made up their minds before the first vote ever came out, before the first primary ever came out. So they can tell you all about this 3 million vote advantage because they're not counting the caucuses and the people or the independents who didn't get to vote. And they can talk about how those superdelegates are only doing what, you know, they feel the need to do because of the popular vote. No, they were already unpopular. But again, it's not too late. And we need to show them that this is what the future is. And this is a future to believe in. They want to keep their jobs. And they want their party to grow. Then shunning you is not the right way to go about it. This is what democracy looks like. Could stare at all y'all all day. I love you.
I love you.
But I don't want to be rude because there's someone else here who wants to say hi to all of you. Beautiful faces. Please, let's give a huge warm welcome to the huge welcome to the oh so wonderful, magical, remarkable Dick Van Dyke. Gandhi's message of be a change that you want to see in the world is a challenge. Be that change.
What's left of the Dick Van Dyke? And I can't tell you how honored I am to be here. There's such hope in the air because you can feel it. It's just wonderful. The spirit. One reason I came here is I'm 90 and I'd like to give you a call if you can. In my 90 years, I've been watching what I feel is the slow disintegration of our Democratic Republic. And to hear Bernie step up and say that emperor has no foes, so be right away. I think we're to blame for some of it. You know, in the 60s, we all gathered together as one, and we did something monumental that the government wouldn't do, and that was civil rights. And it seems to me that the 1% have been very busy and diligent since then to split us up, to drive a wedge between us, to keep us from doing again one of those truly authentic democratic things that we did. We've got to start working together. We must work together. It is my honor to present to you the sanest man in America. Help us, the next president of the United States.
I see what this great country can become. Let me begin by thanking Lily Hayden, Cenk Uygur. And Cenk is doing some enormously important work with the Young Turks. Because one of the crises that we face in this country is that we have a corporate media that talks about everything except what is most important. And Cenk and the Young Turks are trying to remedy that, and they're doing a great job. And I want to thank Rosario Dawson, not only for being one of the great actresses in our country, but for being a fierce advocate for working families and the middle class. And what can we say about Dick Van Dyke? So many of us grew up with Dick, and we appreciate not only his years and years of being a great actor, but also his commitment to social and economic justice. Dick, thank you very much. All right, if you promise not to tell anyone, okay? Got your word?
Yeah!
Keep this a big secret.
All right.
Because I don't want to get Secretary Clinton too nervous. She's very... She's looking very nervous lately. So if you promise not to tell her, we're going to win here in California. And we're going to win for a couple of reasons. Number one, as some of you may know, voter registration here in California among young people and working people is going off the charts. Catching on that they are the future of this country, and they damn well want to help shape the future of this country. So I think that it is great that we're seeing so many young people, working people, who are now prepared to fight to make sure that we have a government that represents all of us, not just the 1%. And here is the other reason why I think we're going to win California and win it big. We are doing something that, as I understand it, is unprecedented in California political history. We are having rallies just like this from one end of the state to the other. Tell you, this is a very warm state, and we're going to have a lot of rallies. And by the time we're ending, we think we're going to be speaking directly to well over 200,000 Californians. And we think that grassroots campaign is going to win us the state and win it big. I was disturbed but not surprised to hear a few hours ago that Secretary Clinton has backed out of the debate. Whoa! A number of months ago, our campaign and her campaign had reached an agreement on a number of debates, including one here in California in May. But I think, I gotta tell you this, I think it is a little bit insulting to the people of California, our largest state, that she is not prepared to have a discussion with me about how she will help the Californians address the major crises that we face. When we began this campaign over 12 months ago, nobody took us seriously. Nobody took you seriously. Well, a lot has changed in the last 12 months. 12 months, we have won 20 state primaries and caucuses. We have received well over 9 million votes.